Sometimes with older photos, they become discolored depending on the environment they're in. This photo was hanging on a wall that had direct sunlight for a couple hours a day for many years. We're going to try to do a couple of techniques to bring the color back into this photo and get rid of some of this red. Be warned though, this is only basic techniques, and no matter what you do, it's never going to go back to its original state. And these are just quick and easy techniques. You can get a little bit more complicated and get better results and better color, but it's going to take a lot longer than the 2 or 3 minutes it's going to take us for this photo. So the first thing we're going to do is try out Photoshop's auto tone, color, and contrast commands. To do that, we'll go up to the image menu and choose auto tone, and then choose auto contrast and auto color. And it did a fairly good job. It still has a little bit of a purple tint, but now we can see the purple velvet of the dress. And yes, it was a very cool dress. And then we see the white ruffles, and we're starting to see some green and pink from the background. However, what this did was it damaged the original photo. Now you're probably saying, well, that's okay, because we don't like the original photo that had too much red. But if you were to save this, and then decide later, no, I want to adjust that again or try it again, well, now you've just permanently changed this original photo. And we never want to do that in Photoshop. So in the history, I'll go back to my first state with the red in the photo. And we're going to do something called adjustment layers. And these allow us to change the color without harming the original picture. So in the adjustments layer panel, which if you can't see that panel, go up to Window and choose Adjustments. From here, we're going to choose the Color Balance Adjustment, and it adds it as a layer on top of the original photo, and it's not harming that original photo, but it'll still change its color. We have a definite problem with the red color in this photo, so looking at these sliders, if we have too much red, we need to balance that color out by adding its opposite, cyan. And as you move that down and make a judgment on what looks good and what doesn't, be aware that people are usually going to look at the face first. And so use the baby's skin tone as a good judge on whether or not you're going too far or not far enough. And if this one has a little bit too much magenta, we can add a little bit of green. And then you can look, and if it has a little bit too much yellow, you can slide it in toward blue. And be aware that you can also change the shadows and the highlights as well, but mid-tones is going to work for us for this picture. Now, if you wanted to refine the color even more, you can do a color balance that's going to make the background look really good, but when you do the color balance that makes that background look good, it's going to affect the face and the skin tone and the dress of the baby here, and it's not going to look good in those areas. So what you can always do is find a mask technique tutorial and learn how to do a mask on this color balance so that it only affects the foliage, then add another adjustment so that you can get the skin tone of her hand and her face just right, add a mask to that, and do the same thing for the dress. If you look at my YouTube channel, there are mask tutorials up there. Now what we can do is we can add other adjustment layers if we need to add some brightness and contrast. And then we can turn the visibility on and off of each of those layers to see if we're liking what's happening with our changes. If we don't like them, we can throw these adjustment layers away and try again. And if we do like them, make sure to save this as a Photoshop file so it keeps those layers intact, which again, it doesn't harm the original photo.